Today, we are going to learn how to export and publish top and bottom stereoscopic 360 VR video with correct 6-channel ambisonic spatial audio for YouTube VR. We are focusing on VR headset delivery, but this will also work great for browser and phone if your viewer are wearing a pair of headphones. And yes, 6 channels, not just 4-channel. There is no video guide at all on the internet to show you how to leverage all the great features YouTube built for ambisonic audio. I hope this tutorial answers all your questions, so let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the number one YouTube channel dedicated to 360 VR storytelling for everyone. To tell a good story in VR, visual is only 50%. Immersive audio is as important as 360 visual for a good VR headset experience, as Oculus Quest, Oculus Ghost, and most of the VR headsets are constantly sold out. VR is so hot right now during the pandemic. As a storyteller, you should learn how to get on one of the largest platforms out there, the YouTube VR. Not like Oculus TV, YouTube VR is available on all VR platforms, including Oculus, Steam VR, PSVR, and so on. If you are going for rich, you should be on YouTube VR like yesterday. But almost no independent content creator knows how to release high-quality immersive content on YouTube VR. So, your boy needs to fill that knowledge gap so you can do it yourself. And it is actually very easy, thanks to Adobe and Facebook. You hear correctly. Facebook has the free 360 spatial workstation software that will help you to encode for YouTube VR and Oculus third order ambisonic for Quest and Go. To capture 360 VR video, you need a professional cinematic VR camera like the Instar 360 Pro 2 right here or the Titan right here. Since almost 80% of my viewers don't own this expensive camera system, you can also use a monoscopic 360 camera to follow along with this tutorial. A good and a very cheap 360 camera with first order ambisonic is the GoPro Max right here. Not even GoPro themselves advertise that feature, but you can use FFmpeg to extract 4-channel spatial audio out from the GoPro Max to use it as your 3D soundtrack. This is a follow-up tutorial of my first ambisonic workflow tutorial right here. It covers the differences between YouTube and Facebook Oculus, what microphone to use to capture spatial audio, and how to get your sound design from Adobe Premiere into Reaper or other DAWs. We are only going to cover export and publish on YouTube VR on this tutorial. So watch that tutorial first and then come back for this one. Not like other popular tutorial from Adobe out there, we are not going to export spatial audio directly from Adobe Premiere. The reason is that Premiere only support 4-channel ambisonic. So your 360 VR video cannot have headlock stereo audio soundtracks. Almost 99.9% of the film or narrative video have stereo background music or sound design that are not spatial. And Premiere cannot generate that. Or at least it cannot generate that for free without the help of third-party VST like what I have here, the Noisemaker Spatial Audio plugin from France. So we are only going to use Premiere to render video without audio and bounce your audio tracks to Reaper or other DAW for spatial sound design. For 3D 360 video in 2020, I recommend this render setting for all delivery. For codecs, I would recommend to use HEVC H.265 for the smallest file size. For resolution, I think 5.7K, which is 5760 by 5760 is more than enough for final delivery on YouTube VR or Oculus TV. In Premiere 2020, your export resolution of H.265 cannot be more than 5968 by 5968. If you want 8K by 8K render in H.265, I will recommend use After Codecs, which detailed it in this tutorial. In post-pandemic era, YouTube server is getting very slow because of the high viewing traffic. I would not recommend upload 8K by 8K 3D 360 video onto YouTube. This will take forever for YouTube to transcode your video, which will affect your release time. Even you can technically upload 8K by 8K video onto YouTube, you should not do it. The bitrate setting, I usually do 60 Mbps for H.265, but sometimes this bitrate is not high enough, especially for high action video. Then you will need to use FFmpeg, as Premiere cannot do more than that. Here is the FFmpeg command line for encoding. If you are using DaVinci Resolve, this is exactly what you need. Please refer to this tutorial for detailed instruction. Render for Oculus Quest and for YouTube VR in 2020 is the same. You should check video is VR and pick the correct frame layout. Here is stereoscopic over and under. Check the maximum render quality. In here, we are getting just the video from Premiere. So uncheck export audio right here, as we don't need the audio at all. Now the video part is done. Easy. Now let's spend the major part of this tutorial on 6-channel spatial audio. Design spatial audio from Premiere to Reaper. So, any good film should have multiple soundtracks. Lavalier mono source from the actors, background music, and sound effects, as you see right here. This is one of my recent 360 VR production. Go watch it on your Oculus Quest. I intentionally pan the audio source around so you can hear the audio jump from your front to the back when the rover is moving on this part. So, how to render all these audio layers? Well, you don't do it in Premiere. You bounce all these tracks into a DAW, Digital Audio Workstation, like Reaper. I would also recommend design your spatial audio in 16-channel, third-order ambisonic for Oculus, following the first tutorial right here. When you have the 16-channel done, making into 6-channel is actually very easy. So, go watch part 1 first and come back when you're done. Okay, I assume you just finished the part 1. Let's recap the export part in Reaper to make sure you did everything correctly. You need to render the 16-channel third-order ambisonic audio without the background music or any sound that should not pan following the viewer's head turn. The background music and not spatialized sound effect should be sent to the headlock master right here. Just to show you the routing again, because it is important. In spatial audio soundtrack with the FB360 spatializer, the routing is 16 channels. To 3D master with 16 channel again. The background music right here is routing to stereo and to headlock master, HL master right here, with stereo 2-channel. When you export 16-channel spatial audio, you first set the render duration by highlighting in Reaper like so. Select only the control plugin track. Click effects button to turn off decode binaural under settings. Very important, don't forget to do that. Now close the FX panel and go to file, render, source is stem, selected tracks, which is the control track. Bounce is time selection. Channel, you type in 16 manually and hit render one file. Now, the 16 channel is done. We select the headlock master again, file and render, stem and time selection again, but in channel, make sure it is stereo as this is a two channel stereo background music soundtrack. Render one files again. Now open Facebook 360 encoder. Select format is B format, first order ampersonic. Select format is B format, third order ampersonic. Load in your spatial audio file 16 channel files output from Reaper here and then hit encode. Now we have a four channel first order ampersonic track just like what you get from the Zoom H3VR or other ampersonic mic like right here. The only thing different is your spatial soundtrack will sound 100 times better than just directly capture audio using the ampersonic mic. And it is produced in a studio, so it's free of noise. Now we need to combine the four channel to the headlock audio master background track to create a six channel for YouTube VR. Angelo from 360 Spatial Audio Facebook group made an incredible guide on how to do that. So full credit to him. Here, I'm going to walk you through how to do it step by step. We are going to use Audacity because it is open source and it's free. Download and install it. First, go to File, Preferences, under Import and Export, choose Use Advanced Mixing Options. Drop in both the 4-channel and headlock master into Audacity. You should see 6-channel now. I assume you already level all your tracks and you should have perfect sounding audios right now. So we are only going to export them. Go to File, Export, Save as Type, Other Uncompressed Files, choose WAV file and 32-bit float. Hit save and now we have a 6-channel audio file ready for muxing. Now we are back to FFmpeg. You can use Premiere, Resolve, or any video editing software to mux your video with audio. I'm going to show you FFmpeg because it is free and open source. Put the video file without the audio and the 6-channel audio source into the same folder of your FFmpeg bin folder. Type this command line on terminal if you're on a Mac or the CMD, the window command prompt on window. Replace video.mp4 to your video file name and the audio.wav file into your audio file name like so. Output.mov, you can replace it with name, whatever name you want. Spatial meta injection. Before you can upload it onto YouTube, you need to inject meta to tell Google this is a 3D 360 top and bottom video with a correct 6-channel ampersonic audio for YouTube VR. So download the Google Meta Injector with the link down below. Drop in the mux video file into the injector. Make sure you check literally everything. My video is spherical 360. My video is stereoscopic 3D top and bottom layout. And my video has spatial audio MBX ACM/SM3D format with headlock stereo. Hit inject meta. Now go ahead and go to YouTube, upload your video just like any other YouTube video. YouTube will recognize your video as 3D and with correct spatial audio. Now if your viewers are wearing a pair of headphones, their mind will be blown by you. Some kids might call it AD audio, like the next cool thing after ASMR, but we know it is a 6-channel spatial audio and it will be the next big thing after ASMR or AD audio. And now you know how to make it correctly. Thank you for watching this pretty technical and necessary tutorial. The knowledge I share here not only apply on 360 VR video, but also game engine design. VR game has to have good spatial audio as well. This is a tutorial request by my audience, you. So if you want more technical tutorial just like this to help you to do your job, you need to tell me in the comment section down below and upvote good suggestions from other viewers. As always, it helped me a lot by liking and sharing this video. Technical tutorials like this do not get enough views compared to my more consumer-focused video like camera reviews. So I will need all your help to keep doing that for you, for free. So smash that like and share button. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay up to date. More spatial audio tutorials are coming. The next one is focusing on Oculus Quest in 2020. So you don't want to miss that one. Stay safe and stay creative, my friend, and I will see you very soon.